Today's video is brought to you by Audible. Get a free audiobook download and a free 30-day trial at audible.com/gregsgadgets or in the link in the description and enjoy over 180,000 titles to choose from on your iPhone, Android, iPad, and even your Apple Watch. I recommend listening to Tim Cook, the genius who took Apple to the next level, to get an inside look at how Apple transitioned from Steve Jobs to Tim Cook and how Tim Cook has helped shape Apple's future. Hey, what's going on, everyone? Greg here, and one of the biggest news stories in technology right now actually isn't even a tech product. Of course, we are talking about Apple's new Apple Card, the Apple Credit Card, and there are a lot of people applying for this card right now, and there are also a lot of people who do not understand why this is such a big news story or why people are applying for this credit card in the first place. And right now, there are a ton of you watching my Apple Card 1 week later review. I'll leave a link up in the description if you want to watch it. But basically, even I am blown away by how much interest people seem to be having in this titanium-backed credit card. But even for the people who are applying, there still seems to be a large amount of people who kind of don't get the reason why the Apple Card is so popular and why a lot of people are choosing to apply for one. And for this video, I kind of wanted to go over the Apple Card craze and kind of explain why this card is so appealing to so many people. Like any good credit card, one of the reasons why people seem to like the Apple Card is its reward system. So this reward system is very simple. So you get 3% cash back at Apple stores, either using Apple Pay or the physical titanium Apple Card. You also get 2% cash back if you are using Apple Pay. And then of course you do get just 1% cash back if you are using this physical titanium Apple Card. Since my last review, Apple has actually added another vendor to the 3% cashback category with Uber and Uber Eats, and Apple says they plan to add more merchants for that 3% cashback category as they go along. So it's going to be interesting to see what type of vendors, what type of stores Apple is going to add to this 3% cashback program. And if the list keeps on expanding, or if it's a rotating list, but if the list keeps on expanding to other stores like Dunkin' Donuts, Starbucks, maybe a grocery store, maybe some movie theater chains, this could be an even more appealing card than it is right now. In my 1 week later review, I said that if you plan on using Apple Pay a lot, this actually had a pretty good reward system with 2% cashback. So if Apple is going to be adding a lot of merchants to that 3% cashback category, this could be even a better card than I said in my initial review. Now, of course, one of the other reasons why people like this reward system is because it's also simple in how you use it. Now, Apple is implementing that daily cashback system, and basically once your transaction is processed, then it adds the cash directly onto an Apple Card right inside of the wallet app, and then you can actually use that cash right from your phone through Apple Pay, and you don't have to wait around for any arbitrary numbers. Like, you don't have to wait for a $25 limit, which a lot of other credit cards have. A lot of people in the comments have been asking if there are any limits, and no, there are no limits. Once the cash is on your phone, you are free to use it however you see fit. So if you want to use it in an Apple Pay transaction, if you want to send it back to your bank, anything you want to do with that cash, it's basically yours. This is personally, I think, a big reason why people like the Apple Card. Other credit cards, even though you do get that reward system, they can be confusing at times. You have to wait a whole billing cycle before you can use rewards. There's some strange restrictions on when you can use that reward. Like I mentioned, some credit cards require a $25 limit. Other credit cards give you cash back, but then you can't actually redeem it for a card. I currently have a Capital One card, and when I want to use my cash back, I can only use it to redeem past purchases. I actually can't get cash in my bank for it. So even if the Apple Card doesn't have the highest tier rewards out there, it is still a very easy and simple to use system for the average consumer, and I think that goes a long way. I think another big reason why people are applying for the Apple Card is Apple's mission statement that they don't want to charge you any fees, or they want to try to help you avoid interest payments. And besides late fees, Apple Card really doesn't have any other fees to speak of, unless of course you are paying interest, which I guess isn't a fee. But again, it doesn't have any sort of foreign transaction fees if you're visiting another country. It doesn't have any sort of annual fees. You're not paying a payment every year just to use your credit card. And even if you aren't prone to having a late fee, or you don't travel, or you're just never gonna even get those fees, I think the consumer does appreciate a credit card company that isn't going to nickel and dime you with those fees. They see that as a big reason to trust the Apple Card. We also mentioned Apple's statement that they want to help you avoid interest fees. Again, this is another reason why consumers might pick that Apple Card. It has a very simple and easy to use interface, and when you're actually going to pay something, it encourages you to pay the full balance. And then if you don't pay the full balance, it gives you kind of these handy little guides to help you pay off that balance in a shorter period of time without accruing too much interest fees. Another reason why people are choosing the Apple Card is it is a super easy and simple process to sign up for. Once you get the Apple Card and you're approved for it, you can actually instantly start using it right within the phone app through Apple Pay or for online purchases. You actually don't even have to wait for the physical card before you can start using your Apple Card. I think another big reason why consumers are choosing the Apple Card is because of Apple's focus on privacy and security. For privacy, Apple says that they will never see anything you purchase on your Apple Card. Now, Goldman Sachs, the bank that backs the Apple Card, will be able to see what you purchase, but on Apple's website, they claim that Goldman Sachs will never sell your information to third-party marketers or advertisers. Basically, Goldman Sachs can use that information, but third parties cannot use it. As for security, well, there are a couple of good security features on the Apple Card. Number one, and the most obvious, is that I can actually show you my Apple Card on camera without fear of you writing down any of my credit card numbers, because the credit card numbers aren't actually anywhere on the physical card. You actually have to go into the wallet app and then go into the information on your Apple Card to even view those numbers. And to get onto your phone, you either have to bypass Face ID or Touch ID, so it is a much more secure process. If you want to be really secure, you can just use your Apple Card with Apple Pay, and every time you use Apple Pay, it just generates a random number, so there's no chance that the merchant can skim your card for information. And if your card is ever compromised in some way, Apple has a really convenient feature where you can request a new card number right with inside the wallet app. So that is a huge benefit if your card does get hacked for some reason. That means you don't have to be without your Apple Card, and you don't have to wait for them to ship you a new one. Also, within the wallet app, Apple does make it simple to manage your Apple Card, so you can see charts of weekly and monthly spending. And you get that nice tight iOS integration, so every time your Apple Card is used, you get a notification, and every time your balance is due, you will also get notifications right to your phone. And yes, I'm sure one of the reasons why consumers are getting the Apple Card is because, of course, of this really cool titanium card, which in this category of credit cards, I don't think there's any other card that offers a metal card. Now, I know this kind of seems shallow. Why would you get a credit card just because it's made out of metal? But I think this does influence some consumers' choice. Because, let's face it, this is a pretty cool looking credit card, and I think that might influence some people to apply for the Apple Card, even if using the physical card doesn't offer the best rewards. Sadly, I think this card is going to become some sort of a status symbol, and that kind of feels icky to say, but I'm just trying to express reality here. And you can tell that Apple is really proud of this titanium card. I mean, they even have cleaning instructions on their website on how to take care of your Apple Card. What other credit card company is doing that? I can't really think of any. So, we covered a lot of reasons on why consumers might be choosing the Apple Card as their next credit card, and I know a lot of people out there still aren't going to get it after this video. They're going to say you can get better rewards elsewhere. You can combine other different types of credit cards, like getting an Amazon Prime card with 5% cash back on Amazon, and then maybe getting the Citi Double Cash card, or this card, which offers rotating rewards points. But I think at the end of the day, people like the Apple Card because it is simple and easy to use, and it's very hassle-free. You don't really have to worry about a lot of the other stuff that other credit cards kind of make you manage. You get a very simple and easy to use understanding system with that rewards points, and then you can use it pretty much instantly with that daily cash feature. And I guess that's just kind of it. Apple is making it a simple process for almost everything, from applying to using your rewards, to viewing your card information, from security to privacy, to even not having fees. Everything is pretty simple to understand. And I think that's why the Apple Card is probably going to be a big hit with a lot of consumers, is because it is just a hassle-free credit card. And I know a lot of people are going to still dismiss the Apple Card as something that isn't important, and in the grand scheme of things, is a credit card that important? Probably not, but I still think it is an important news topic to cover, especially with so many people applying for this card. I want to give everyone out there the best information possible so you can make an informed decision on which credit card you should apply for, because honestly, using a credit card is a big financial responsibility, and if you are applying for the Apple Card or for any credit card for that matter, please make sure that you are paying on time even if there is no late fee, because you don't want to accrue interest and pay a lot of interest on your cards. So please pay on time, please pay your balance off in full, and please do not go into any sort of credit card debt to buy any sort of product. Credit card debt is a really, really big problem, and I can tell you, not having any debt on your shoulders is a nice feeling to have. All right, everyone, I hope this video helped you out in understanding why people are choosing to apply for the Apple credit card and why it's such a craze right now in the tech world. If you like this video, make sure you give me a like. If you want to see more from my channel, make sure you subscribe. If you want to help the channel out in any way, make sure you check out some of the links in the description. And as always, I will see you all in the next video. Take care, everyone. And then you can also get 1% cash back whenever you use...